Okay, now I'm back. I've, like I said, put the liner on. I did my waterline all the way into the inside of the tear duct, put on some mascara. Also, while I was gone, I put on some blush. That's a little NARS Silvana blush. And they tend to kind of put it in the contour area more than on the apple of the cheek, from what I see. All right, so now I'm going to show you how to use a loose pigment, loose, on the other side. But still show you, you know, how I normally do it with a base and that sort of stuff. So again, Urban Decay Primer Potion was already put down and set. And this is MAC's Bare Study. It's just a sample I have. I'm gonna go ahead and pat that on the lid. I think it's drying up. Got it all down into my under eye area and everything. I got fat fingers from my eyeballs. Okay, so we're just gonna use a regular eyeshadow brush. This is the, I think, this is called the smudge brush, but I think it's from Target. But I like it, because it's small, see? And very, very dense, because for smudging they normally are. It's a little soft for smudging. I'm really liking this one, the Sephora smudger. For actual smudging. I don't think I've shown you guys that though, like I haven't used it in video. Alright, so after you've got your base down, you just load up your brush right into the dry powder. I normally, like I said, I like to use what's on the lid, and then just make sure to really tap off any excess so you don't have any fallout. And we're going to do the same exact thing. We're going to pat it on and build it up over that base. And again, all over the lid. And just barely up into the crease. But I don't know if you guys can already see. See how it's, I mean, it's certainly shimmery and pretty, but it's nothing like doing it wet, where it was metallic and very, very smooth looking. Here it's almost crepey. See? It looks like I took the whole pot of eyeshadow and just stuck it on my eyelid. So it gives a different effect. Alright, so now we're going to go into Heritage Rouge, do the same exact thing. I'm going to load up the brush, tap off any excess. This is a really dark color, so you want to be really careful. And we're just going to build it up. And I'm being really gentle, because I'm, like I told you guys, I'm kind of scared of this color. It's so dark. Alright, so that's the first pass. I guess I was being a little too cautious. I'll just build. Oh, but see, I didn't tap it off, and I got it on my cheek. Right there. See it? Alright, I'm trying to get the matching intensity as the other side. In this situation, though, I would still use the same blending brush. So this is the Sonia Kashuk pointed blending brush. I think it was $4.99 at Target. Loading up the tip. And you see how it really goes into my crease. Come in. You didn't, it's not locked. Yep, cool. All right, I'll be out in a second. I'm almost done now. So we keep loading it up, building it up till we get the desired intensity. Now I'm starting, I used up all the color on that, the lid, so I'm getting it off the sides now. Oh, it's a little time consuming. But, alright. You see still, it's not as shimmery and metallic looking. This one, I like this one a lot. So thank goodness I'm not going anywhere, because I would look like a crazy freak with two odd eyes. Alright, so now I'm going to go ahead and put my highlight on. I got some fallout too, it looks like. I'll have to clean up. I didn't put any under eye concealer on yet because this burgundy color, I was, you know, afraid if I got it anywhere, it would look really harsh. All right, so we're gonna repeat the same process on the lower lash line, but this time I'm gonna put it on dry using the quarter inch Old Cornell Maxi Mouth Brush. So loading it up, starting with the lighter color first, so less time spent cleaning the brush off. And doing the whole lower. You know why I probably couldn't get it as dark on the outside? Is because I brought the gold all the way across. I bet you that's why. Now that I think about it. This is all a learning process for all of us, including myself. I haven't really played with this color since the cat got into my pigments that one video. I'm trying to make this color work. And it didn't. So primarily, I think that when you wear your pigments wet, they're more intense in general. But you can always see here too how it applies to the lid. Alright, so I'm going to put on my liner, put on my mascara. I'll be right back. I'll do my lips too while I'm gone. And say my goodbyes. Alright guys, so there's the finished look. I'm not sure with it all complete if it really is that different. Well, the burgundies are. Outside of that, I think everything else looks, from a distance, looks the same. On my lips is Creamy Nude by Clinique over top of a nude liner by ULTA. And my new favorite little funny thing to add is this Flirt gold shimmer that I put on top. So I'll go ahead and take some pictures. Hopefully this video isn't too long and I had to put it in two sections. But I hope you guys like the look and I learned a little bit about how to use loose eyeshadows. So I'll talk to you later. Bye for now. I just wanna know today, know today, know today. Know that maybe I will be okay. Know that maybe I will be okay. Know that maybe I will be okay. Thank you.